Okay, since we have talked about tangent, let's take one question on finding the length of the tangent. Okay, I'll take a very simple one. Find the length of the tangent. Find the length of the tangent drawn from the point 3 comma minus 4 to the circle 2x square 2y square minus 7x minus 9y minus 13 equal to 0. Super simple problem. I just want to test whether you are aware of that formula which I discussed with you a little while ago. Please, four tangents. How can there be a four tangents from an external point to one circle? Nitya, there can only be one, there can only be two tangents from an external point to a circle. I think you're getting confused with the common tangents. Common tangents to two non-intersecting circles. Yeah, I'm getting only two values of m, right? So two possible tangents are there. So I got m value as 0 and minus 8 by 15 only. So only two values, so two tangents are possible. So in this case, guys, if you recall the length of the tangent I had already discussed with you, since many of you are traveling, I'm sure you are not able to write. Is that the reason why you're not responding? So length of the tangent is under root of S1. Okay. But remember, when you're finding S1, first find your S out. S is going to be not this, but it is going to be x square plus y square minus 7 by 2x minus 9 by 2y minus 13 by 2 equal to 0. So S1 is when you substitute the point in this. Okay. And when you do that, you are going to end up getting 26, I guess. Let's simplify this. So this is going to be 25. This is going to be minus 21 by 2 plus 36 by 2, which is 18, minus 13 by 2. Okay. So which is 25 plus 18 minus 34 by 2, which is 17, which is 26. So length of the tangent is going to be root of 26 units. Next concept that we are going to talk about is the concept of pair of tangents. Concept of pair of tangents. Now, to any circle from an external point, let's say x1, y1, we already discussed that we can form a pair of tangents from this external point to this circle. Okay. Now the combined equation of these pair of tangents, which you can draw from a point P onto this circle, that is PT1 and PT2. The combined equation is given by the expression T square is equal to SS1. Okay. So let's say this equation of this circle is x square plus y square is equal to a square. Then what is t? Please be aware of these following notations. S is this. S1 is this. And t is going to be this. T is going to be xx1 plus yy1 minus a square. Okay, so the combined equation of the pair of tangents that you can draw from an external point to the circle is xx1 plus yy1 minus a square whole square is equal to SS1. This is SS1. Okay, now the question is, how do we get this equation? What is the proof for this? Okay. So basically what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take some arbitrary point, let's say alpha, beta, on this tangent. Okay. I'm going to take an arbitrary point alpha, beta on this tangent. Now we know that if I know two points, I can easily find the equation of a line by using the two-point form, right? So y minus y1 is equal to slope times, so this is going to be your slope, times x minus x1. Okay. In other words, if you simplify this, you are going to get y times alpha minus x1 minus x times beta minus y1, and you're going to get minus alpha y1 plus beta x1. So it'll be plus beta x1 minus alpha y1 equal to 0. Okay. Now we know that the perpendicular distance of this point, of this line from the center of the circle, is going to be your radius of the circle. Right? So I can say distance of 0 comma 0 from 1 is going to be a units. That's the radius of the circle. So I can use the distance formula, mod this by under root of coefficients of x square and y square. This is going to be a. Okay. Square both the sides, you will get beta x1 minus alpha y1 square equal to a square times alpha minus x1 square beta minus y1 square. Okay. Now basically, the equation of the pair of tangents is the locus of alpha and beta, isn't it? Locus of alpha and beta is equal to the equation of pair of tangents. This is something which you need to understand. So it becomes a locus question once again. Okay. So what I'll do here, I'll replace my beta with y and alpha with x. Okay. So when we do that, you get yx1 minus xy1 square is equal to a square x minus x1 square y minus y1 square. Okay. If you open the brackets, I mean, it's just a simplification process which you can do it at your end also. If you open the brackets, you get y square x1 square plus x square y1 square minus 2xy x1 y1 equal to a square x square x1 square minus 2xx1 y square y1 square minus 2yy1. Okay. And if you further simplify it, you end up getting y square, take common from both the sides, so you'll get y square x1 square minus a square. Take x square also common, you'll get y1 square minus a square. Okay. Minus a square x1 square plus y1 square equal to 2xy x1 y1 minus 2a square xx1 minus 2a square yy1. Okay. Now just add x square x1 square y square y1 square plus a to the power 4 on both the sides. Okay. If you do that, y square will have x1 square plus y1 square minus a square common. Similarly, x square will have x1 square plus y1 square minus a square common. And not only that, a square will have x1 square plus y1 square minus a square common equal to 0. Oh, sorry, is equal to this side will have. This side will have x x1 y y1 minus a square whole square. And guys, this is nothing but x square plus y square minus a square times x1 square y1 square minus a square is equal to x x1 y y1 minus a square whole square. So hence proved. Now the proof of this is not important. The proof for this is not important, but yes, this result is very much important. This result, especially this one, is very, very important. T square is equal to SS1. Why it is important is because if you change your circle to, let's say, a general form of the equation of a circle, you can still use this formula. So let's say if your circle was, if your circle equation was x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, then we can write the equation of pair of tangents. Pair of tangents can be written as t square. T will be this. This will be t. Okay. T square will be equal to s. This will be s. S1 will be this. Okay. So this is a universally used formula irrespective of which type of circle you are dealing with. Okay. But I would strongly discourage you to use this method. You'll say, why? Then why did you teach it? See, there are easier ways to find this answer if you have been provided with the external point and the equation of a circle. As you would recall, the previous question that we did, finding the equation of a tangent drawn from an external point 1, 4, that approach would be a much better approach to solve this kind of problem. Okay. And that will actually give you the equation of a pair of tangents in separated form also. Okay, let's see a question where we can implement what I'm trying to say. So first find out the pair of tangents. Find the equation of tangents from the point 3, 2 to the circle x square plus y square plus 4x plus 6y plus 8 equal to 0. Plus 8 equal to 0. Okay. Now again, there are two ways. You can use the formula which I gave you. That is t square. What is going to be t over here? What is going to be t over here? T is going to be x, x1, y, y1 plus g, x plus x1 plus f, y plus y1 plus c equal to 0. Correct? So x1 is your 3, y1 is your 2. So your t expression would be 3x, 2y, g will be 2 times x plus x1, f will be 3 times y plus y1 plus 8. Okay, you can further simplify this. 3x plus 2x will give you 5x, 2y plus 3y will be 5y, And 5, 6 plus 6 will be 12, 12 plus 8, which will be 20. Okay. So you can write the equation as this square is equal to S. This is your S. That is the equation of the circle itself. S1 is when you substitute the point into this, which is going to be 3 square, 2 square, 12 plus 8, which is going to be 9 plus 4, 13. 13 plus 32, which is going to be 45. Okay. So you can take common 5 outside, so which will be 25 times x plus y plus 4 whole square is equal to 45 times x square plus y square plus 4x plus 6y plus 8 equal to 0. Okay, so you cancel out a factor of 5 and this is 9. Okay, and open this, you'll get x square plus y square plus 16 plus 2xy plus 8y plus 8x equal to 9x square 9y square plus 36x plus 54y plus 72. Which on simplification will give you 4x square, 4y square. If I'm not wrong, you'll get minus 10xy. You will get minus 4x plus 14y minus 8 equal to 0. Okay. Woo, that was a big, job to be done. Now the same thing gives me an equation of a pair of tangents. This is the pair of tangents equation. So I don't get the individual tangents from it. I get a combined equation of a pair of tangents. Okay. How do I separate those individual equations from it? That's another task. So for that, all of you, please listen to this carefully. You drop the factor of 2 from everywhere. So when you drop the factor of 2 from everywhere, this is what you get. Okay. How to break this into two lines? That is what I'm going to discuss. First, focus on the second degree terms. That is 2x square, 2y square, minus 5xy. Try to factorize it like this. Okay. Forget about the rest of the terms as of now. So take 2x common, x minus 2y. Take minus y common, x minus 2y. Okay, so it can be factorized as, so it can be factorized as 2x minus y times x minus 2y. Okay, now since other terms are also present, it is very evident that there has to be some constants over here. Let me call it as P and Q. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is that when you multiply these two lines, you end up getting this pair of straight lines. Pair of tangents is nothing but pair of straight lines. Okay. Now try to compare the coefficients of x. So x coefficient will be 2q plus p. Correct? And that will be equal to minus of 2. Try to compare the coefficient of y. Y coefficient will be minus q minus 2p, and this will be equal to 7. Okay, let's solve for p and q. Let's multiply this with 2 and add them. You will get minus 3p is equal to 12. So p will come out to be minus 4. Now if p is minus 4, we directly know that p into q will give you minus 4. Correct? So p into q is minus 4. So q will be 1. That means if I have to write this pair of tangents as two separate lines, it would be 2x minus y minus 4 times x minus 2y plus 1 equal to 0. That means individually your tangent equations will be 2x minus y minus 4 equal to 0 and x minus 2y plus 1 equal to 0. But this, I do not recommend using this method because of too much of work involved. Instead, you could use the method which we discussed just before we took this problem. Okay. So there is a circle. Okay. And this circle is x square plus y square plus 4x plus 6y plus 8 equal to 0. Okay. That is, it is a circle with center at minus 2 comma minus 3, and it has a radius of under root of g square plus f square minus c, which is under root of 5. Okay. So guys, what can we do over here? Is there any method to solve this problem? Okay, so what I'll do now, I will assume the tangent, let the equation of the tangent be y minus 2 is equal to mx minus 3. So I'm assuming m to be the slope of the tangent. And since it is passing through 3 comma 2, I can always assume the equation of a tangent to be this. Okay, y minus 2 is m times x minus 3, which automatically gives me the equation as mx minus y plus 2 minus 3m equal to 0. Okay, now I can get the value of m from the fact that if I drop a perpendicular from the center of the circle, it's going to be at a distance of, it's going to be of length root 5. So I'm going to use the distance formula now. That is m into minus 2 minus y mod divided by under root 1 plus m square is going to be root 5. Okay, so please simplify this and find the value of m from here. It's a simple quadratic in m. Tell me the value of m. So if you simplify this further, you will get mod of 5 minus 5m by under root of 1 plus m square. This is equal to root 5. Okay. Square both the sides. If you square both the sides, you get 25m minus 1 square is equal to 5 times m square plus 1. So you can cancel off the factor of 5. So 5m square minus 2m plus 1 is equal to m square plus 1. That gives you the equation as 4m square minus 10m plus 4 equal to 0. Okay, which is nothing but 2m square minus 5m plus 2 equal to 0, which you can factorize as 2m square minus m minus 4m plus 2 equal to 0. Take m common and take minus 2 common. So you get m minus 2 times 2m minus 1, which means m is 2 or m is half. Okay. The moment you get this, guys, your job will be pretty easy because we have already written the equation of the two tangents. What are they? The equation of the tangent is going to be y minus 2 is equal to mx minus 3, right? So replace your m over here one by one. So first put 2. When you put 2, you automatically get y minus 2 is equal to 2x minus 6, which means y minus 2x plus 4 equal to 0 is one of the tangents. Let's call it as t1. And when you put half, you get 2y minus 4 equal to x minus 3, which means 2y minus x minus 1 equal to 0. Let's say it's tangent 2. So this work is much easier as compared to what we had done in the previous scenario. Right? In the previous scenario, we had sat and found out the equation of pair of tangents, and then we had split the two tangents from it. Okay.